Over the last few years, many writers and entertainers have been waxing lyrical about the 1980s Alfa Romeo GTV, and rightfully so. But not about this one. This video is brought to you by Carl Friedrich, maker of quality premium luggage like this beautiful carry-on trolley. Stick until the end of the video to know all about it and get an exclusive discount code. Introduced in 1974, the Alfetta GT came to replace the much-loved Giulia-based GTs, a difficult task made even more challenging by the period's circumstances, as widespread social unrest and high fuel prices weren't exactly conducive to sports car sales. Nevertheless, the market responded positively to the new Alfa's attractive combination of four-seater practicality, performance and style. The Alfetta GT's attractive body sat on an Alfetta Saloon's platform with an 11 cm cut from the wheelbase. Giorgetto Giugiaro penned its sharp lines, conveying a feeling of dynamism and speed through the strong inclination of the windscreen and rear window pillars. Modern and individual at launch, the Alfetta GT aged very gracefully indeed, and was in many ways still fresh by the end of the 70s decade. This certainly proved to be a blessing for the Alfa Romeo designers tasked to refresh the GT's appearance for the 1980s. The Milanese company had been hemorrhaging ever-increasing amounts of money since 1972, and product development resources were therefore scarce. As major tooling expenditures were out of the question, Alfa's designers had to concentrate their efforts on ancillaries and trim, leaving the steel body's pressings unchanged. Following period trends, all the previously shiny exterior trim was blacked out. The outdated stainless steel bumpers were replaced by chunkier grey plastic items. Under the front bumper, a large grey plastic spoiler reduced drag and increased stability at speed. The taillights were reunited into large clusters, while the front indicators migrated from the body to the bumpers. The Alfa Romeo shield became a smaller, more stylized affair on the black front grille. While the end result certainly looked more contemporary in period, I can see why many 1980s GTVs were bought in either dark grey or black, because brighter shades like this classic Alfa Red we see on this beautifully preserved example show off all the added plastic trim in a perhaps less than flattering way. When the new model range debuted in 1980, the big news was the introduction of the fuel-injected 2.5-liter V6 engine as the new range topper. The GTV6 2.5, easily recognizable by the bonnet bulge needed to accommodate the larger power plant, sounded like angels in heaven. Delivered performance comparable to period air-cooled Porsche 911s. On top of that, the GTV6 went on having quite a successful motorsport career. Therefore, it's no surprise that the 6-cylinder GTV kind of overshadows the 4-cylinder models, to the point some may have forgotten they ever existed. The GTV 2L was exported in most European countries, but certainly owed much to the Italian market for its continued existence. Alfa Romeo sold most of its cars on the home market, after all, where punitive taxation for engines over 2L of displacement led most buyers to settle for the 4-cylinder GTV. Under the restyled GTV 2L bonnet, there were no surprises. The engine was the classic all-aluminum twin cam 4, fed by the traditional pair of double-choke 40mm side-draft carburetors and rated at 130 horsepower and 132 pounds-feet of torque. This gorgeous survivor wears a lovely set of Chromodora Turbine 14-inch alloy wheels, but these weren't factory-fitted. Italian GTV 2L buyers were reminded of their inferior status by the rather ungainly 14-inch steel wheels fitted as standard. 15 inches alloys similar to those fitted as standard to the V6 model were available as an option, but similar is the keyword here. The 4 and 6 cylinders GTVs had different hubs, with 4 lugs for the lesser version and 5 for the V6. 40 years on, those optional alloy wheels specific for the 4-cylinder GTV are now quite hard to find on the second-hand market. Despite the coupé's short wheelbase, the interior offers quite generous accommodation to 4 passengers, although headroom is limited by the roof pillars' inclination. The Alfa Romeo GTV was a sophisticated machine aimed at discerning buyers. But you never tell once you step inside, where sadly, most of what you see and touch feels rather more Togliattigrad than Stuttgart. In keeping with Alfa Romeo tradition, albeit with the less than endearing part of it, the interior of the 1980s GTV feels like an afterthought. Fit and finish are subpar even by 1980s standards, and seemingly no consideration whatsoever was given to the ergonomy and ease of operation, with controls scattered on the dash and console at random. But this is a classic Alfa, and everything is forgiven once you step on the gas. Twin Cam 4 pulls eagerly while singing its lovely tune, making the driver's testosterone levels soar in tandem with the engine's revolutions. Better not get too carried away with the gear changes though, as this still is an Alfetta after all. These sophisticated transaxle models have a long gear lever linkage that demands patience and mechanical sympathy from the user. Russia downshift, or the critical first-to-second change during acceleration, and your clumsiness will be punished with a sonorous grind first and premature synchromesh wear further down the line. To love classic Alfa Romeos is to appreciate traveling in style. That's why I believe our video's sponsor, Carl Friedrich, is an excellent fit for this channel. They specialize in premium quality Italian leather bags and accessories that come with a lifetime warranty. I really dig the minimalistic style of this beautiful carry-on trolley. The light polycarbonate shell has an aluminum frame for extra strength, and the TSA-approved combination locks look and feel like they last a lifetime. Attention to detail is evident throughout, from the lovely leather accents on the exterior to the interior lining and the zipped containers. One of them contains a USB cable connected to a port neatly hidden under the trolley's handle. Plug a power bank inside and you'll be able to charge your phone on the go wherever you are. The same sharp design and peerless quality is now also available in the larger check-in model on the Carl Friedrich website.